Hey guys, and welcome here on this Den of Time channel. Today we are going to build a really simple medieval house with the Den of Time mod. So we are just going to simply start with always odd numbers for the foundation of the building. So something like maybe 9 and 7. So I use here the stone brick masonry to make the foundation of the building. As you can see, it's a connected one, so it makes the wall flat. Once you have done your foundation, you of course make the floor just here. Once you have finished your foundation with odd numbers, you are going to start to build the walls. So I'll always do the same thing. Sometimes I try to put blocks higher and upper, so I'm going to take 5 here and 7 here, maybe 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then I'm going to connect here. So I always love to make different level of buildings, so something around this maybe. Yeah, perfect. So I'm going to use the timber frame with this one, and then this one I'm going to make it one block beside, just to make different roof. And you're going to see how it's important, because it looks really nice once it's fully done. Once we have done the frame, you are simply going to put waxed oak planks in the empty squares or rectangulars, just in order to fill up all the gap in the walls. So I just finished to fill up all the gap with the waxed oak planks, and I just noticed that I did a mistake here. I took PN numbers, so I'm just going to add one layer here to get an odd number. So 5 is always good to make a nice roof. So I'm just going to move all these parts from here to here. I just add one block, and then we already start to get a really nice shape. And I'm going to make a small entrance, maybe on the side here, maybe. Could be a good idea here. Or I could also make it here. But I think I'm going to let it here. Once you have done this, we are going to start to make the roof. So it's absolutely simple. You just take your stairs and you are going to put it on the highest block of your buildings. So just like this, you see it's really simple. Always trying to let the roof go one block in front of your walls. So once you have done the start of your roof, you are going to add the flat roof tiles edge, just like this. Then you are going to add one block, one stairs, edge, then block, then plate. It's going to look like this. Here you can also put, if you want, maybe a plate like this. Okay, so edge, block, edge, I add another stairs, edge, block, edge, and then plate. You have one block remaining here and you put a stairs in it. So it's a really simple roof, really classical design I always make with this kind of small buildings. Once you have your first curve, you are going to make your second curve just right here. I'm going to start it here. So I'm going to make at some point the same design, but I want to make it a little bit complex. So you have your edges, then your block, you add your edge, your block, and then I'm going to add a plate. I'm going to use two plates connected to each other just right here. So I started to make this kind of curves with stairs, edge, block, double plate, block, plate, and block. So I'm going to repeat the same thing just right here. As you can see, I also completed this part of the roof, and we are starting to get a really nice curve. I think I'm just going to reduce this one. Okay, I think I'm going to let it like this. So we have a thicker part here and a thinner part here. So it really makes the roof going like this in a really nice curve. Once you have done that, you are just going to repeat this pattern all over here and this pattern all over here. So once you have completed the roof in the two parts and you have connected each other, you are going to get this kind of shapes, which is really nicely looking. I'm just going to make some correction here just to get a better shape for the roof. As you can see, because this one is a bigger roof, so it needs to get this priority instead of this one, which is a smaller roof. So once you have done that, you are going to, of course, complete this part of the empty part of the buildings. So you correct this, you use always the timber frame pillar to make pillar and the timber frame corner to make corners. So it's really, really, really simple. And then you are going to repeat this pattern on the other side. So once you have finished to complete all the upper part of your roof, I'm going to work on the second part of the tutorial, which is the connections. So the connection is something I always do in my buildings. Once I have made all the rectangular shape, I'm trying to add a bit more variety on the front of the houses. So I'm going to start like this. I always use the support beam as a foundation for the connection, and then I make this kind of pattern, just three or two blocks, it's always nice. I put the support slab here, my windows, of course my shutters, and then a little pink geranium planter here. I use the edge to make a small roof, and then this like that. So it's really simple, it's really nicely make your walls better, and then I'm going to repeat it on all the other sides. So maybe here we can also make a connection, as you can see, like that. So you make absolutely the same thing. So three blocks, you make a gap in the wall, you put your windows, your shutters, the support slab here, and your pink geranium planter. You use the edge here to make the roof more integrated. Once you have that, I always like to make it a little, yes, like this. Try to make it nicely integrated in the wall building. And here I can also add maybe some, yeah, pergola like this to make a connection from this point to this point. You see, nice. Here I made another connection like this. I can maybe make another connection on the connection. You are going to see it's really nice and nicely looking and really simple. So once you have made your connection, you are just making another one on top of it. So here I can do maybe a small little tiny connection. I take my edge and I cover it like this. You see always, always the same pattern. So it's really simple, really nicely looking. I'm going to use this, the geranium here, here. And for that, I'm going to use the little shutters like this. So here I made a double connection to remove the empty aspect of the wall. So here what I often do is a chimney. I'm going to make a chimney here to reduce the flat aspect of the wall. So really simple, always try to make at least one or two chimney per buildings, because it helps you to make better and better walls. Okay, I'm going to add a little bit of details in the chimney with the cobbled limestone, which is really nicely looking when both of it are like this. Like this, yup, yup, yup. Okay, nice, perfect. And as I did on the other part of the building, I'm going to add my connection here. I put my windows, yep, my shutters, my pink geranium, and then I make the wall like this. You see, really simple, really easy, going to take this. You see? Simple, easy, nice. Finally, it only remains this part of the building, which really need some love. So as always, I'm going to make the simple connection like this. I put the support slab, the windows, the shutters, and the pink gerneon planter. Of course, I add the edge for the roof. As always, you see, I'll always repeat the same pattern all over. Just I'm mixing the size of the windows, or the placement of the windows, or the way it is connected to the roof, and it makes already nice looking house. And I don't even touch a lot of stuff. What I always love to make is a pergola in front of the building entrance. So I'm going to make it like this. It's really nice. It really looks nice because it adds some green aspect of the building. And I love so much making some green parts on my buildings. It always adds a bit of color. So yes, always nice to. Nice to take. So once you have finished shade, make the shape of the pergola. I'm just going to add some extra details. Maybe here I'm going to put it one block upper to make it nicely integrated. And I'm going to add, of course, the grape on it to make it nicely looking. It's so good. I just add here a little pillar. And then you have a wonderful pergola connected to your house, which add a little bit of green color to the buildings and goes so nice with the white and gray and orange tone of it. I'm probably going to work a little bit on the outside, maybe with stairs. I'm going to put the door here. We could put a little candle just right here. I'm going to light it. We could make maybe a windows just here to add a little bit of light in the buildings. It already start to nicely look. I'm going to add, I think, an entrance here. As you can see, I just use really simple build axe. I think it's a classic way to make a nice looking granary or cellar. I still don't know the word. And as you can see, the arrow slit looks so nice from the outside. It really adds a little bit of extra decoration. And yes, always nice to get. It will make some medieval aspect. So I love it. Once you have done that, I'm going to work on the overall details of the exteriors. So I'm just going to add some variation on the timber frame. As you can see, it's just going to add a little bit of details on the buildings. So I always use the timber frame corner to remove the pillar and the squared and the crossed to remove the edge, the timber frame corner. As you can see, it's really simple. I always repeat same pattern. So I remove this. I put the cross on the edge. Here I always add the squared. It looks so nice on top of that. It also looks nice to make little details like this on the connection. And as you can see, it just add a little bit of extra details. It's always nice to get a nicely detailed house, even if you don't use a lot of blocks. I think it's what makes Dawn of Time truly shine. It's simple blocks that are nicely used. It's really like that we try to create this mod around. I'm probably going to add, I think, a connection here. I just want it to be symmetrical with that. So I think I'm going to put it here. So really simple. You put timber frame like this. Absolutely simple. You put your windows. I'm going to take the little shutters plus the geranium. You see, I put my geranium here. Little shutter here. And then I just simply put the block. I think I'm going to use stairs here, maybe. You see, stairs. I put this one beside. And this one, I think I'm going to make it like that. Oh no, just like that. You see, just little extra window. And to make it even shiner, I'm going to add this one here and this one here. And you have a perfectly balanced Windows, just right here. You see, it just add a little bit of details. And I think I'm going to make this one upper. I'm just going to make this one upper because I wanted to see it from this side. Perfect. You see, just have something that go a little bit upper here to at some point break the curve, the line here. Just have this part here. I think I'm nearly done with this house. I'm going to work on the inside and I'm going to finish the tuto here. Okay, so for the inside, I'm going to use really simple tips. I'm going to put the chimney here, as you can see. Nice. I'm going to enlight it. Perfect. Maybe a little chest here. No, I'm going to keep the chest for the roof part. I'm going to add some stuff like this with chairs like that. I'm going to add I think I'm going to add the geranium here on the table. Yes, because done of time, furnitures have an inventory in it, so you can put stuff in it. I'm going to make a small carpet here, two blocks here and here. I'm going to add maybe a candle, ice, one chest here. And another block here with one biblio here. Yep, like that. Simple, efficient. Once you have done your interior, I'm going to work on the upper part of the roof. So I'm going to use birch lattice as ladders. I'm just going to remove this block and then I'm going to work here. So, really simple, I take the support beam with the support slab. I'm just going to make really simply, I'm going to keep it simple like that. So two beams in cross to make the this part of the roof. And then I'm going to go here, break that in order to get a bit more space. Maybe I'm going to add a little chest here. I don't know if you make your building in survival, I don't know. I'm going to add this. A little bit of extra decoration, I think. I'm going to choose this one. I'm going to add one at here. Little carpet in it. And it is really simple and really nicely looking. Done with the house, guys. I just added some little extra oak leaves on some sides to add a little bit of decoration. I think this is the end of this tutorial. I made a really nicely looking house, really simply. As you can see, there is nothing complicated. I just repeat all over the same and the same building pattern. I build the foundation in square, then I add the work timber frame pillar plus the corner ones. Then I add the roof, then I add the connection on the walls to add some extra thickness. Then I add details, so the pink geranium planter, the pergola, the arrow slit, the door. I had some leaves, all this strange little stuff, the chimney, the details in the roof, and then you get a really nicely looking house. Because with this kind of method, you can reproduce nearly an infinite amount of houses. As you can see, all my houses are built with the same pattern. They are kinda looking all the same, but are never the same. It's just that I mix all the stuff. So I put this time here, this time here, this time here, this time here. It's just about mixing your patterns, and you can still get the same patterns, but mix it in different ways. So as you can see, it makes all times different houses. And I think we are done with this house, guys. It was a really, really simple and nicely looking little house. As you can see, there is really nothing difficult. Do not hesitate to subscribe and hit the bell. The notification bell of this channel. Do not hesitate to join me on a stream. I try to stream every day on Twitch, so maybe you can go ahead and try to look what I'm doing in live. And thank you for watching, guys, and see you next time.